Prizegiving. I base my remarks around the school motto, I spurn to change or fear, which those of you who follow closely will remember I translated into more modern language as courage and conviction. The sense that we must have values and we must have the courage to stick by those values. And speaking in the context of independent education in the modern age, this is no less true during this year. Without a doubt, independent schools and independent education in the narrative of the public domain are considered to be the problem, not the solution. And that could not be further from the truth that we so feel powerfully in this hall. It is absolutely imperative that we do all we can to cast our sort of school doing what it does in our local environment as a force for good, not at all a problem that society needs to deal with. Following the lead that the captain of school has given me, I thought I'd base these remarks around two slogans that have become very popular in recent weeks. Yes, strong and stable, but also for the many, not the few. And I intend to argue that independent schools are both, even if no one else turned out to be. We are strong, without a doubt. There are more boys in the division than there were at the start of the recession in 2008. The school flourishes, and we have looked at many of those achievements already this evening, and I'll mention more. Our bursary funds are larger. We support one in five boys, not one in six, when I arrive. We have been keen on fees to maintain that social mix. We are unequivocally an engine for social mobility. And every statistic published in the press used to argue that we are a problem, looked at from another perspective, argues that we are the solution. In fact, we are a strength for the UK. And that strength has been important for the education of all. The strength of the large independent schools in this country has allowed us over the last 2 years to have very successful campaigns looking at the fairness of exam marking. It was the independent schools, from their position of strength, that of course we are not engaged in special pleading because our results would be bad. We are interested in fair marking because our results need to be fair. And in doing so, we have moved that issue forward for all pupils, not just pupils in independent schools. Our strength and independence allows action and freedom of thought without fear. It is the strength of the independent schools that has allowed us to be vocal on a national stage about mental health issues for teenagers. That can only be done if you are strong and secure in your own beliefs, because the obvious thing that will happen next is that the newspaper headline arguing that everyone in an independent school is mad will come. It did. You probably read it in the Sunday Times. We are not. We knew we were not, but we knew that young people needed a voice, not least to engage with the social media agenda. Strong schools can do that because we have that security of our own mission. And only last year, it was the independent schools who spoke out against the absurd initiation ceremonies becoming ever more popular as boys and girls go on to university. And we can do that. We can do that because universities cannot think badly of us because of the supply of top quality students that we provide. It is a really important message, one that is not easy to vocalise on the national stage against the prevailing wind, that the strength of independent schools is a strength for all schools because we give voice to educational issues that affect everyone. And our stability is important in that as well. That strength comes from the sense of permanence, the sense of continuity, a touchstone in an educational world that is, always has been, and doubtless always will be, changing. Politicians dealing with state education cannot help sometimes for good reason, but meddle. The permanent stability and strength of independent schools provides ballast against that. We have been the schools providing the students in strategically important and vulnerable subjects for universities and for the economy, science, technology, engineering, maths, but also modern foreign languages. 49% of people in the country study GCSE in a modern foreign language, less than half. Here, everyone does. 4.5% study two GCSEs in a modern language. Here, more than a third of the boys study that second language. The UK needs scientists, engineers, mathematicians, those interested in technology, those who can communicate in foreign languages. And the stability of independent schools is where that strength comes from. Building a model that all can follow. But if you weren't keen on strong and stable, perhaps your flavour was for the many, not the few. And we can do that as well. I've already hinted at how we do that. Our strong and determined position on what represents a good education reflects on changes in education for the whole of society, not just the pupils in independent schools. We have and strive for a good social mix in the school. When the Good Schools Guide visited some years ago, I tried to argue that point and met some resistance. But I still assert, because I believe it to be true, that we are one of the most diverse schools in the Northwest. All other schools are less diverse in some fashion. That, of course, is possible because of our bursary fund. Of course, we're an elite. The boys want to feel they are part of an elite. But we are not elitist. We are normal people going about our business and doing it well for the good of society. It is the outreach and partnership we do as well that makes this school in Bolton for the many, not the few. Our impact on our hometown is so much larger than educating 900 senior school boys. Let me just give some examples where not only we have had impact locally, but also led the way nationally. The Bolton Sports Alliance, a mixture of third sector organisations enriching primary school PE provision. That model was presented at a national conference within the last month and may be followed by others. In 2011, we had the first Ogden Teaching Fellow in the country. There are now 30 or so. We designed the model, others followed, and that is how it should be. Our partnerships with schools such as Esser and Smithills, where those are organised, strategic, have specific aims, and are evaluated and led by joint partnership groups. Those models will prevail over the next few years, rather than random acts of kindness with particular schools. Our charity work, community action, all speak to this same theme. It may be in practice, whilst I can entertain myself on an evening such as this, sharing those thoughts with you, it will prove impossible to prevail on the national stage. This argument may be terminally toxic. But what I'm sure we can do is prevail with this argument locally, having it understood where it matters to us that Bolton School is a force for good in our local community.